Do you have a check engine light on your dash regarding some oxygen sensor faults, or you've noticed your fuel economy is really bad? Well, my name's Cole from FCP Euro, and today we're gonna show you how to replace all of the oxygen sensors on your N63 equipped G05 X5. In front of us, we have the OE upstream Bosch oxygen sensors and the downstream genuine BMW oxygen sensors. Both of these could be found at fcpeuro.com, and they are covered by our lifetime replacement guarantee. So what is an oxygen sensor? It's a device that is inserted into the exhaust stream to monitor the exhaust and send information to the engine control module. How can we dictate if the oxygen sensors are bad or need to be inspected? Well, the obvious is a check engine light on your dash, but some other things could be poor engine running conditions and really bad fuel economy. That is why we recommend having a scan tool on hand to inspect to see if there's any fault codes indicating that we need to do something with the oxygen sensors. BMW actually has a service interval for the N63 engine behind us on the oxygen sensors, and they recommend every 150,000 miles to replace these. But if you are experiencing some running issues with your BMW, you may have to replace the oxygen sensors before 150,000 miles. Now that we've gone over everything on the table, let's get into the tools that we're gonna need for this DIY. For sockets, we're gonna need a 22 millimeter oxygen sensor socket and an 18 millimeter socket. We'll need a long extension and ratchet, along with a torque wrench that can torque to 56 Newton meters. Some variation in pick tools, a flathead screwdriver, and optionally, to make the job a lot easier, we have some ratcheting ropes, a magnet, and an electric ratchet. Now that we've gone over all the tools, let's hop into this DIY. Now with the hood open, the first thing that we can do is come over to the engine cover and remove it by just pulling up slightly on all corners, and it's gonna release this cover from the rubber grommets. We wanna be careful when we're doing this because we can snap off the pegs quite easily. All right. Now the upstream oxygen sensors are located right here underneath the airbox. They put a nice hole for us to access. So the first thing we can do is start disconnecting all the electrical connectors. Now coming over here, we're just gonna press this tab and then pull that connector off and then slightly pry this out of its holder. Be careful, these are plastic, and over time and heat cycles, they could become very brittle and break. Now, if this connector is not coming out of this holder easily, we can grab a little flathead screwdriver to use to pry it to the side. And we want to be very gentle here because these can break. All right, now we can start fishing this upwards towards the airbox. You'll see that it's holed all the way in just with these little hooks. And then we can repeat that process on the passenger side. This side holder for the connector is already broken and there's a zip tie on it. So we're just gonna cut the zip tie off and then disconnect everything. With a 22 millimeter oxygen sensor socket, we can remove both of these oxygen sensors. Now, one thing to note here, you're gonna wanna do this when the engine is cold, because when the engine is hot, the torque values can differentiate. And then when you torque it when it is hot, you will not be able to get it out next time. So we have that broken free here. So now we can just thread this driver's side oxygen sensor out and move on to the passenger side with the same procedure. If you are reusing these oxygen sensors, be sure to not tangle all of the wiring and try not to twist it. Now, as you can see, while we're removing this, I'm using my right hand to spin the wiring in the direction that the oxygen sensor is rotating outwards. And the reason why I'm doing that is to not tangle all the wiring. However, we're going to be installing new downstream oxygen sensors in this vehicle, so follow us along as we remove the strut braces. With an 18 millimeter socket, extension and ratchet, remove the two bolts holding on the strut brace and then repeat the process on the driver's side. This bolt is a little tricky to get to, so that's why having an extension makes it a little easier. With a flathead screwdriver or a 6 millimeter socket, you're going to want to loosen the clamps on both sides of the engine bay. we're gonna reach back in the engine bay and pull this air box off of the rubber grommets. Now, it is a little bit tough and tricky, so you have to have a little bit of patience, and you may make some grunting noises as you pull this up. With this air box now loose, we can slide off this rubber boot and then come down below and disconnect the air duct from the air box and push it back. We're gonna repeat the process on the driver's side. Now that that's all free, we can pull the air box out. To make routing the electrical connectors and wiring for the oxygen sensors a little bit easier, we're gonna remove these three clips that hold on these pipes and then remove some more BMW plastic. There's a little retainer on these charge pipes. Now, as you can see in my hand, I have a little clip here that is installed onto the turbo discharge pipe to hold that clip in. These are not required and an item that is installed at the factory, so you can choose if you want to reinstall them or not. We'll get underneath here with our 90 degree pick, pop that off, set it to the side, and pull this off of the turbocharger. It's a little bit stiff, so just be careful when pulling it off, and then we can push it to the side. I'm gonna be using a ratcheting tether here to hold this out of the way. It's definitely useful in this scenario. Coming over to here, we're gonna pop this clip up, pull it off, and then remove this hose as well. And the last clip to remove this pipe is gonna be located down by the turbocharger inlet, and then we can just remove that clip as well. These clips do tend to pop off quite rapidly, so having a magnet is nice to be able to fish these clips out. Now, with that plastic pipe removed, you can repeat that process on the other side. Now, with all that plastic out of the way, we can start disconnecting the wiring for the oxygen sensor. We're gonna start with disconnecting the connector, and we have to pull that connector off of its holder. It's quite hard to see, so I have our new oxygen sensor here. We're gonna have to get a 90 degree pick on the backside and push this over to be able to release this and pull the connector off of its mounting place. With a 90 degree pick, we can come and release this connector lock and then pull out to get this connector free. Now, as you can see, it's a little bit tricky to depress that tab and get it all the way off. So we can always take our 90 degree pick, get underneath this tab and pull it off that way. With that now free, we can come down here, push that locking tab that we showed you earlier to the side and slide this off. Continue removing this wiring by taking it out of all of the holders here, and then we are going to remove the cover for the oxygen sensor. Pay attention to the routing because it is important that it goes in the same exact way it came out. Now, this thing looks like a Scotch-Brite pad, but it is very important to put this back because it keeps all that heat from the turbochargers out of the engine bay. We're just gonna fish it off the wiring and push it to the side. Taking our 22 millimeter oxygen sensor socket, we're gonna go on top of the sensor here, crack it free, and then spin out the rest by hand. Now that we have this one removed, let's go remove the other oxygen sensor on the other side. Now on the passenger side, we're gonna remove this fresh air duct to make it a little bit easier to get to the wiring. So we're using a 90 degree pick here to just get underneath of this and release that tab so we can push it to the side, slide over to the opposite side and disconnect that clip over here. With both of those tabs released, we can pull this fresh air duct towards the back and out of the vehicle. Again, these are those tabs that we were just showing you that we're gonna depress with the pick. Now we can repeat that same exact process with disconnecting this electrical connector and removing the wiring for the oxygen sensor as we did on the other side. As you can see, these electrical connectors are quite fragile. Good thing we're replacing this oxygen sensor right here. Now, as you can see, those gray locking tabs can slide out really easily. So if you did what I just did, you're gonna have to go fishing for that locking tab to reinstall into this connector. We're gonna keep moving on and removing this oxygen sensor. As you can see, that is very tricky to do. We can now repeat the process on fishing out all the wiring and pulling out the oxygen sensor. Now, both the genuine and the Bosch oxygen sensors come with a little bit of anti-seize already on the threads. So with our new oxygen sensor now, We're going to thread it into this hole by hand. As you see, as we're rotating this oxygen sensor, we're also rotating the wiring so it doesn't get all twisted. And then come back with our torque wrench and tighten these to 50 newton meters. Now, before we route all this back together, since this ejected from the connector, we're just gonna clip this all back in. There we go. Now, around the oil filler cap, we're gonna come right over here, twist this connector a little bit, and then this little groove right here, we're gonna slide onto this holder and then push up. And then just give it a little wiggle, make sure that's not going anywhere. This connector is gonna be a three-stage connector, so that means that it's gonna have three points of locking. First, we're gonna push this on, and then we're gonna push it forward. You can see that whole connector pushes forward, and then we're gonna push this locking tab in. Now, with our fresh air duct, we're gonna slide this back into the port that is down there, and then just make sure that those two locking tabs clip in. Give it a little tug, make sure it's not going anywhere. Now, let's go over to the other side and repeat the same exact process. Grabbing our plastic intake pipe with all the clips back on it, we can take a little bit of engine oil on our finger and just lubricate all the points that we're gonna be clipping in. Now drop this down back into the engine bay and pop it onto the turbo first. Wait for that click, give it a little tug, make sure it's not coming off, and then reconnect this breather line. Now repeat that same process on the passenger side. Now with both of these pipes secure, we can come back and install the clips back on our turbo discharge pipes and clip them back onto the turbo. Again, a little bit of oil on your finger. We're just gonna lubricate this seal and then clip it back on. If you notice any tears on this seal or that seal, this is a good time to replace those. And those parts will be linked in the description below. Nice click. With that secure, let's go grab our airbox. Now you may have noticed when we removed this, it was quite hard to pull off the rubber grommets. That's why when we're putting it back in, a little bit of glass cleaner on these rubber pieces can make popping it down a bit easier. Now we have that done, we can drop this back into the engine bay and reconnect the fresh air ducts and the ducts that go to the intake. And again, we can just take this little glass cleaner and lubricate all of these junctions just a little bit, not too much. We don't want too much on there to help sliding this on a little bit easier. There we go. Now with all these slid on, we can press down and lock it into place. You're gonna wanna repeat that process on the passenger side. With a flathead screwdriver or a 6mm socket, we're gonna wanna snug down these intake boot clamps. Don't go too tight, because they aren't under boost pressure, but we do want to seal this area nicely. We're going to tighten the boot clamps on both sides. With our new OE Bosch sensor, we can thread this in to the hole that is on the passenger side and then come back and tighten it to 50 newton meters. We can now repeat that process on the driver's side. With both of these sensors now tight, we can route all of our wiring back into their place and connect the electrical connectors. Yep, this holder is broken, so we're gonna zip tie this back into place. On the driver's side, we'll do the exact same thing. Now there is a clip that goes here to hold the wire just like this. However, our vehicle is missing it, so we're just gonna tuck this here nicely. Clip this back in and then place it back into this holder. We can now reinstall these strut braces with new hardware because they are one-time use. We're not gonna torque these bolts to spec because we're actually gonna have to pull these out for another DIY coming to you next. However, the torque specification for these bolts is gonna be 56 newton meters plus 90 degrees. One fun fact from the factory, this hole is not threaded. And when they put these bolts in at the factory, they actually cut the threads. So, if you take these cross braces out in and out a bunch of times, you can actually damage the threads because it is aluminum and not steel. So we're just trying to be a little cautious here and not ruin these threads. and then we'll just come back with that 18 millimeter socket and tighten these down. Repeat that process on the driver's side. Now for the last and most satisfying job for this, we're gonna lubricate all of our rubber grommets with some glass cleaner, pop this engine cover on, and then we're done with our DIY. That's not going anywhere. If you liked the video, please hit that like button. And if you have any comments, questions, or concern, drop them in the comments section below. And if you wanna see more G05 X5 DIYs and other vehicles, hit that subscribe button because we have a lot more coming to you. My name's Cole from FC Fiero. Thanks for watching and keep on wrenching.